do nothing for the girl, of course. It was Dr. Bell who thought she might somehow be taught. I've written a family owner that a suitable governess, Miss Annie Sullivan, has been found here in Boston and will come. It will no doubt be difficult for you there, Annie. But it has been difficult for you at our school, too. Gratifying, yes, when you came to us and could not spell your name. To accomplish so much in a few years. But always an Irish battle for independence. This is my last time to counsel you, Annie. And you do lack some, by some I mean all, what tact or talent to lend to others. And what has saved you on more than one occasion here at Perkins is there was nowhere to expel you to. Your eyes hurt.
My ears, Mr. Anonymous.
Nowhere but back to Tewksbury, where children learn to be saucy. Annie, I know how dreadful it was there, but that battle is dead and done with. Why not let it stay buried?
I think God must owe me a resurrection.
What?
Well, he keeps digging up that bat.
That is not a proper thing to say, Annie. That's what I mean.
Yes. But I know what I'm like. What's this child like?
Like?
Well, bright or dull, to start off.
No one knows. And if she is dull, you have no patience with this?
And grown-ups, you have to, Mr. and Agnes. I mean, in children, it just seems a little precocious. Can I use that word?
Only if you can spell it.
Premature. So I hope at least she's a bright one.
Blind, deaf, mute. Who knows? She's like a little safe, locked, that no one can open. Perhaps there's a treasure inside.
Maybe it's empty, too?
Possible. I should warn you, she is much given to tantrums.
I mean, something is inside. Well, so might I believe all I hear. Maybe you should warn them.
Annie, I wrote them no word of your history. You'll find yourself among strangers now who know nothing of it.
Well, we'll keep them in a state of blessed ignorance.
Perhaps you should tell it.
Why? I have enough trouble with people who don't know.
So they will understand when you have trouble.
The only time I have trouble is when I am right. Is it my fault that so often? I won't give them trouble, Mr. Anagnus. I'll be so ladylike they won't notice I've come.
Annie, be humble. It's not as if you have so many offers to pick and choose. You'll need their affection working with this child.
I hope I won't need their pity.
No, we could all use some pity. So, you are no longer our pupil. We throw you into the world a teacher. If the child can be taught, no one expects you to work miracles, not even for $25 a month. Now, in this envelope, a loan for the railroad, which you will repay me once you have a bank account, but in this box, a gift, with our love. I think other friends are ready to say goodbye.
Mr. Anagnus? Dear Mr. Anagnus, well, what should I say? I'm an ignorant, opinionated girl, and everything that I am, I owe to you.
That is only half true, Annie.
Which half? I crawled in here like a drowned rat. I thought I'd die when Jimmy died. That I'd never again come alive. Well, you say with love so easy, and I haven't loved a soul since. Never will, I suppose. But this place gave me more than just my eyes back. Or taught me how to spell, which I'll never learn anyways. But with all the fights and trouble I've been here, it taught me what help is. And how to live again. I don't want to say goodbye. Don't! It's open.
Where are your eyes?
I'm putting them on now.
Don't go, Annie, where the sun is fierce.
Do they fit on?
They fit just fine.
Are they pretty?
My eyes feel hundreds of percent better already. And pretty, why? Do you know how I look in them? Splendid, like a racehorse.
We have another person on your head. Yeah, we can hear them.
Beautiful.
Make sure you tell me.
I promise it will be the first thing I give to her. If I don't keep it for myself, that is. You know I can't be trusted with dolls.
Don't go, Annie, to her.
Sarah, dear, I don't want to go.
Then why are you going?
So I'm a big girl now. And big girls have to earn a living. It's the only way I can. But if you don't smile for me first, what I'll just have to do is...
What?
Put you in my suitcase instead of this doll and take you to Helen, Alabama.
Oh, come, children. Let's get the trunk into the carriage and Annie into a trailer. No one will go to Alabama.
I
miss you all so much.
Sullivan, age 9, virtually blind. James Sullivan, age 7. What's the matter with your leg, Sonny?
Oh, never.
Can't you walk without that crutch?
No.
Girl goes to the woman's ward and boy to the men's.
Annie! Annie! Don't let them take me! Annie! Annie!
No!
Annie! Annie!
Yes, I'm coming. Yes. All right, come along, children. Come along. Thank you.